couples divorce. But now you don't have to cry about it. You can have a party. CBS News correspondent Sandra Hughes has the latest on this new trend.
After years of being single and then a whirlwind romance, Kim Williams tied the knot with a fizzle.
My marriage was ugly and it was very hard to go through.
And when those divorce papers came,
that is definitely worth celebrating.
There were a few tears, and then she was ready to party. Kim is embracing her future, surrounded by friends at, what else? A divorce party. To get rid of the memories and mementos, she slapped a for sale sign on her wedding dress and altered the wedding day photos. She put her ex-husband's face on a dartboard, and to drive home the point, she even created X toilet paper.
Even now, with divorce so commonplace, getting an invitation like this to a divorce party celebrating the end of a marriage might be slightly shocking.
With celebrity breakups in the news every day, the shame of being divorced may be losing its sting and celebrating the end gaining steam. Author Laura Dave has written a book about the trend. In her novel, The Divorce Party, she talked to dozens of couples calling it quits.
And I started hearing a lot about this idea of having a compassionate divorce party, which is when two people get together at the end of their marriage to sort of celebrate everything that came before, as opposed to feeling acrimonious that it was over.
But just plain over was the theme of this party when Kim Williams cut into this cake. She was celebrating singlehood. Sandra Hughes, CBS News, Monterey, California.
And Laura Dave is with us this morning, along with Charlotte Hewlett, head of Celebrant Foundation and Institute, a company that plans divorce ceremonies. Welcome to you both. Charlotte, what is a divorce ceremony? Are both people present, both people who are trying to divorce each other?
Most of the time when there is a divorce ceremony, we honor a specific person's transition from being a married person to being a single person.
I.e. freedom.
Yes. So occasionally we may have it where there is both the ex-husband and wife are part of the ceremony, especially if there's children involved, because we want to make sure that the children know that even though mommy and daddy are no longer married, they are still family. We are still your mommy and daddy. So there are certain couples that wait, of course, till after the fact that they've been divorced, and maybe some time has gone by, and they want to have a divorce ceremony, more so a family ceremony if it's both the ex-husband and the wife.
And what happens at these ceremonies? Obviously, one where both parties are present, there's no dartboard like the one we just saw.
No, there's no dartboard. I mean, a divorce ceremony usually has more dignity, more personalization, and be able to take a look at the life that they had together, or the person that was divorced, what they had in the past, and honor all of those moments that they had, and also the fact that they are now going to the next stage and they are a single person.
Okay, of all the divorce ceremonies that you have performed or, you know, help coordinate, how often are both parties actually present? I just don't see that happening.
It doesn't happen often. It's mostly one person coming to us saying that they, you know, been through a divorce and they signed their final judgment, and they now want to proceed with some kind of a ceremony where they can thank their families and friends for supporting them. They've gone through the emotional.
Laura, let me ask you, because you interviewed a lot of couples going through a divorce, just recently divorced for your book. How often did you find people wanted to have this sort of ceremony, and how many of them wanted to have their soon-to-be ex-spouse at that ceremony?
Right. You know, I think it has a lot to do with the intention of that celebration. I spoke with a lot of people at different points in marriage, primarily because my book is about a woman who's trying to start a marriage in the face of watching her parents, you know, divorce, watching her fiance's parents divorce, which is so prevalent in my generation. And so I did find a lot of people who, in the interest of helping their children heal, wanted to do something that was nice, but more than not, you have to really be ready for that. And if you're not, the celebration is about yourself, it's about moving on, it's about freedom. And you even have to be ready for that, because sometimes there is still anger.
Yeah, I would say so. It seems like a little bit like the party we saw, it was promoting a little bit of the anger with the dartboard. Mm-hmm. Is that a healthy way to go about acknowledging your newfound freedom? Charlotte, Laura?
I don't really think so. I think that sometimes people have this concept of the stigma of divorce, where people feel that, oh, now is the time for me to break loose. You know, I've been through so much. And I think we look at it in a comic way. It's like this comic tragedy. And I don't think that's really the way to go. I think that people can maybe do something where they're having a little fun, but at the same time, a divorce party is one thing, but a divorce ceremony would honor this transition.
The final word, Laura, what's the biggest thing you learned about marriage or divorce in writing your book and all the research you did?
The number one thing I found out is that people still believe in lifelong commitment, and they'll be brave enough to try with someone or try again.
Thank God. It was getting so depressing here. Laura Dave and Charlotte Hewlett, thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
For more about divorce parties, go to our website, earlyshow.cbsnews.com. Up